The Monarch Total RNA Miniprep Kit can be used to extract and purify up to 100 micrograms of total RNA from a wide variety of sample types, including cultured cells, blood, and various tissues. Tough-to-Lyse samples such as plant, bacteria, and yeast can also be processed with this kit with a few added steps. The protocol consists of two parts, sample disruption and homogenization, and RNA binding and elution. Because of the kit's versatility, the protocol for part one differs according to your sample type. For simplicity, we have divided this video into chapters to address the sample types individually. For details on processing samples previously stored in TRIzol, Monarch DNA RNA Protection Reagent, or RNAlater, or for instructions on how to use this kit for RNA cleanup, please refer to the protocols in the product manual, which can be found at neb.com/T2010. Part 2, RNA binding and elution, is almost identical for all sample types. So after viewing your specific protocol for Part 1, please tune in to Part 2. It is important to work in an environment free from RNases. Always wear gloves, use RNase-free glass and plasticware, and clean your work areas. We recommend wiping benchtops with a cleaning agent such as RNase Zap. Next, we'll prepare the following reagents. Reconstitute the DNase 1 by adding nuclease-free water to bring the final concentration to 1 unit per microliter. For the 50 prep kit, add 275 microliters, and for the 5 prep sample kit, add 55 microliters. Gently invert to mix, do not vortex, and keep on ice until ready to use. For subsequent storage, prepare aliquots and store at minus 20. Reconstitute the proteinase K by adding proteinase K resuspension buffer to bring the final concentration to 20 mg per mil. For the 50 prep kit, add 1,040 microliters, and for the 5 prep sample kit, add 250 microliters. Vortex to mix and keep on ice until ready to use. After use, store at minus 20. Add 4 volumes of ethanol greater than 95% to the RNA wash buffer concentrate. For the 50 prep kit, this will be 100 mils, and for the 5 prep sample kit, this will be 6.4 mils. Keep in mind that sample lysis and all subsequent steps of the protocol should be carried out at room temperature and not on ice. This will prevent the formation of precipitates in the buffer. Part 1, sample disruption and homogenization for cultured mammalian cells. Mammalian cells, either in suspension or pellets, are readily lysed in RNA lysis buffer without the need to add proteinase K. First, pellet cells by centrifugation at 500 times G for 1 minute. Starting with the cell pellet, resuspend it in the appropriate amount of RNA lysis buffer by pipetting gently to prevent foaming. Keep the sample at room temperature instead of on ice to ensure that the detergent in the buffer does not precipitate. For a frozen cell pellet, thaw the pellet briefly at room temperature for approximately 30 seconds before resuspending in lysis buffer. Now you are ready to move on to step 1 of part 2, RNA binding and elution. Part 1, sample disruption and homogenization for mammalian whole blood. For a standard prep, up to 200 microliters of whole blood is processed. Up to 3 mils of blood can be processed on a single column, but will require scaling the corresponding reagents and reloading the column. Starting with an aliquot of whole blood, add an equal volume of the 2X Monarch DNA and RNA protection reagent to the sample and vortex briefly to mix. For frozen aliquots of whole blood, add an equal volume of the 2X DNA RNA protection reagent to the frozen aliquot and thaw quickly with vortexing or shaking. Add 10 microliters of proteinase K to the mixture, vortex briefly, and then incubate at room temperature for 30 minutes. Next, add an equal volume of isopropanol to the sample and vortex briefly. Now you are ready to move on to the RNA binding step in part 2, RNA binding and elution. It is important to note that for whole blood samples, you will skip the gDNA removal column and the addition of ethanol. And instead, you will load the isopropanol sample mixture directly onto the RNA purification column. Part 1, sample disruption and homogenization for tissues or leukocytes. Before beginning, it is important to refer to the product manual or to our website to find out the recommended amount of starting material. Using more than the recommended amounts will affect your yields and purity. For frozen samples that are not stabilized in DNA-RNA protection reagent, ensure that the frozen material remains frozen until your samples are mixed with the protection reagent. Frozen tissue powder produced by manual homogenization in liquid nitrogen may also be used. Keep frozen tissue powder that has not been stabilized in protection reagent also frozen until mixed with protection reagent. Fresh tissue materials should be kept on ice during preparation. Also, make sure that tissue is cut into small pieces to ensure rapid lysis and high yields. First, determine the amount of 1x DNA and RNA protection reagent needed and prepare it by diluting an aliquot of the 2x concentrate with nuclease-free water. Add the appropriate amount of 1x DNA-RNA protection reagent to your sample. At this point, the sample may either be digested with proteinase K directly, or the sample can be mechanically homogenized with a bead homogenizer prior to proteinase K digestion. Mechanical homogenization typically results in higher yields. For mechanical homogenization, transfer the sample in the DNA-RNA protection reagent to an appropriate tube containing beads for homogenization. Place the tube in a bead homogenizer and homogenize the sample according to the manufacturer's recommendations. If multiple rounds of homogenization are required, place the sample on ice for approximately 1 minute between rounds to prevent the sample from overheating. Transfer the homogenate to an RNase-free microfuge tube and spin for 2 minutes at 16,000 times G to pellet any debris. Next, transfer the supernatant to an RNase-free microfuge tube. Following the addition of protection reagent, samples are ready to be digested with proteinase K. For every 300 microliters of sample DNA-RNA protection reagent mixture, add 30 microliters of proteinase K reaction buffer and 15 microliters of the proteinase K enzyme. Mix by vortexing briefly and incubate at 55 degrees for the time indicated. Vortex the sample briefly and spin for 2 minutes at 16,000 times G to pellet any residual debris. Transfer the supernatant to an RNase-free microfuge tube. Next, add an equal volume of RNA lysis buffer and vortex briefly. Now you are ready to move on to part two, RNA binding and elution. Part one, sample disruption and homogenization for tough-to-lyse samples, including bacteria, yeast, and plant. Tough-to-lyse samples such as bacteria, yeast, and plants have robust cell walls that do not respond to lysis by detergents and proteinase K. The use of glycanase enzymes, which are not provided with this kit, can facilitate the lysis of cell walls in tough-to-lyse samples. Details on reaction conditions can be found in the product manual on our website. Alternatively, mechanical lysis methods, such as using a bead homogenizer, allow efficient disruption of these samples. In this video, we will use a plant sample as input, and beads are used to disrupt the frozen pulverized plant leaf prior to RNA isolation with the Monarch Total RNA Miniprep Kit. First, add the appropriate volume of 1x DNA-RNA protection reagent to the frozen sample and then quickly mix by pipetting or vortexing. Transfer the sample to an appropriate tube containing beads for homogenization. Place the tube in a bead homogenizer and homogenize the sample according to the manufacturer's recommended settings. For plant tissue, multiple rounds of homogenization are recommended. Place the sample on ice for approximately 1 minute in between rounds to prevent overheating of the sample. Transfer the homogenate to an RNase-free microfuge tube and spin for 2 minutes at 16,000 times G to pellet any debris. Next, transfer the supernatant to an RNase-free microfuge tube. Add an equal volume of RNA lysis buffer and vortex briefly to mix. Now you are ready to move on to part two, RNA binding and elution. Part two, RNA binding and elution. RNA purification using the Monarch Total RNA Miniprep Kit is divided into two parts, sample disruption and homogenization, and RNA binding and elution. By now, you should have viewed the video for part one relevant to your sample type. If working with whole blood samples, please proceed directly to binding to the RNA purification column. Binding to the gDNA removal column. All centrifugation steps should be carried out at 16,000 times G. First, label the collection tube because the column will be discarded after this step. Add up to 800 microliters of lysate from part one to the genomic DNA removal column, which is the column with the light blue ring. And spin it for 30 seconds. This column binds a large majority of the gDNA present in the sample, allowing the RNA to flow through. Discard the column and save the flow through because this flow through contains your RNA. Binding to the RNA purification column. To prepare your RNA for binding to the RNA purification column, add an equal volume of ethanol, greater than 95%, to the flow through from the previous step and mix by pipetting. Do not vortex. If you want to exclude small RNAs less than 200 nucleotides, only add half the volume of ethanol to the flow through. Transfer the ethanol sample mixture to an RNA purification column, which is the column with the dark blue ring. And spin it for 30 seconds. Discard the flow through. Binding to the RNA purification column for whole blood samples. For whole blood samples, transfer the isopropanol sample mixture from part one to an RNA purification column, which is the column with the dark blue ring, and spin it for 30 seconds. Discard the flow through. On-column DNase 1 treatment. This step is optional but recommended. Add 500 microliters of RNA wash buffer to the column and spin for 30 seconds. In an RNase-free microfuge tube, prepare a master mix of 75 microliters of DNase 1 reaction buffer and 5 microliters of the reconstituted DNase 1 enzyme for each prep that you will perform. Apply 80 microliters of this mixture to the top of the matrix and incubate for 15 minutes at room temperature. Washing your RNA. Add 500 microliters of RNA priming buffer and spin for 30 seconds. Discard the flow through. Add 500 microliters of RNA wash buffer and spin for 30 seconds. Again, discard the flow through. Then, add another 500 microliters of RNA wash buffer and spin for 2 minutes. Eluting your RNA. Transfer the RNA purification column to an RNase-free microfuge tube and add 100 microliters of Monarch nuclease-free water to the column matrix. Spin for 30 seconds to elute. For a more concentrated RNA elution, you can elute in 50 microliters. Place the eluted RNA on ice immediately if you plan to use it for downstream applications. Store it at minus 20 for up to a week or at minus 80 for long-term storage. RNA can be evaluated for purity and concentration using a standard microvolume spectrophotometer, such as a nanodrop. When taking a sample to measure, it's good practice to spin the eluate and pipette from the top to avoid any silica particulates that may have eluted from your column. If you have any questions, our scientists would be happy to help. Please contact us at info@neb.com or online at neb.com/tech support.